It's a shocking and disturbing crime. A fifth grader accused of shooting his father's girlfriend, who was 8 months pregnant. CBS News correspondent Priya David is in Newcastle, Pennsylvania with the latest. Good morning, Priya.
Maggie, good morning. Even though the boy is only 11 years old, prosecutors plan to try him as an adult. He's being held here at the Lawrence County Jail, about 15 miles from where this unexpected tragedy took place.
Homicide is rare in the little town of Wampum, Pennsylvania. And the killing of Kenzie Marie Houck, more than 8 months pregnant, is especially shocking considering who police are charging with the crime. Her boyfriend's son, 11-year-old Jordan Brown.
This is something that you wouldn't even think of in your worst nightmare.
I wouldn't know anybody in the whole world would want to kill a 26-year-old beautiful daughter like mine and take a child.
Police say Brown shot his father's girlfriend point blank as she lay sleeping Friday morning. They say the weapon was the boy's own youth model 20-gauge shotgun. The boy allegedly returned his gun to his room before hopping on a bus with Houck's 7-year-old daughter, headed for school as usual. Police picked him up there some hours later after Houck's 4-year-old daughter found her mother's dead body. Neighbors and family have speculated that the motive was jealousy, but police have not yet provided any evidence to support that claim.
If we believe that the child may have been jealous of the situation with a mother who is not his birth mother and the impending birth of another child by his father and this woman, you would expect jealousy.
Brown is reportedly being held in a private 10-by-8-foot cell here, being watched by guards. Because he's a minor, he can't mingle with the general population. Even allowing the boy to shower would apparently mean shutting down an entire cell block with dozens of other inmates. Now, Brown's attorney has said the boy has not confessed to the crime. He further says there's been no animosity between the boy and the father's girlfriend. And he says the boy should be out on bail and back in school. Maggie.
CBS's Priya David. Thank you, Priya. Joining us also from Newcastle, Pennsylvania this morning is Lawrence County District Attorney John Bongiovanni. Good morning, John.
Good morning.
It's so hard to imagine a little boy shooting this woman in the back of the head at close range. Some people who knew this boy say that he didn't do it. Are you certain he committed this crime?
I'm certain enough to charge him with the crime at this point, based on the statements of the sister and the corroborating evidence and circumstances that we have found, yes.
Can you tell us a little more specifically what you have? When you say the sister, who do you mean?
It wouldn't be the sister, I apologize. It would be the victim's 7-year-old daughter that went to school with him. Mm. She'd indicated that he had come downstairs with a weapon wrapped in a blanket. She goes into the other room and hears a loud shot. He runs back upstairs, comes back down, and they exit to go to school. And along the driveway going to the school bus, he throws something out of his pocket. We find the 20-gauge shotgun in his room. The shell casing that was recovered along the driveway was also a 20-gauge. In addition, we believe that it was a 20-gauge BB shotgun mm-hmm. shell that killed Kenzie.
So you allege that this boy killed his father's girlfriend and then went off to school like nothing happened. Have you heard of his demeanor since then? Seems like he went on as if it were an ordinary day.
And that's the reports that I got from when the state police spoke to them and even up to the point where they arrested him, that there was little, if any, emotion out of them.
All right, we should quickly address the fact that in Pennsylvania, anyone who's older than 10 suspected of murder has to be charged as an adult. Do you think that's a little harsh for this boy?
Well, under the facts and circumstances, it's tough to answer that question, whether it's harsh. There's a lot of varieties involved, and sometimes you just can't look at the age of the child, or the juvenile in this case. You have to look at his mental capabilities, his mm-hmm. status, and there is a procedure in Pennsylvania where he can be transferred back to juvenile, and all those factors and circumstances are looked into,
right.
And then the judge would make a decision based on that.
All right, John Bongiovanni, thank you so much for your time this morning.